Hi, I'm Mike Stanton with Build America Mutual. I'm here with Les Richmond, BAM's pension actuary. Les is the author of the new BAM white paper, Pension Funding Adequacy and Municipal Credit Analysis, Techniques for Identifying and Emerging Credit Risk. And he's going to be here to talk a little bit about why he wrote the paper and what you found when you looked into the issue. So let's start at the highest level. Why is it important for municipal bond investors to care about pensions? How does that fit into their analysis?
Well, investors and BAM as well are very concerned about whether a bond issuer will be able to pay its debts in the future. And one key consideration in doing that type of thinking is the idea that certain costs, pension and other post-employment benefits among them, may grow to such a level in the future that they could crowd out an issuer's ability to pay their debts.
So as you've explained in a series of articles and white papers for BAM, there are a lot of moving parts that go into pension risk analysis. This paper takes a really deep dive into one of them, the adequacy of pension funding policy. So what is the funding policy and how does that work into your analysis?
Well, BAM has an extensive analysis of pension and other post-employment benefit risks. And part of it is quantitative, so that involves developing certain metrics that speak to the affordability and sustainability of these costs over the time we're going to insure the bond. But the qualitative aspect of it relates to how risks can be affected by certain factors, and a key factor is funding policy. So basically, a funding policy is the method by which contributions that are paid into pension funds are calculated.
And so ultimately, what are the questions you need to answer about, after you identify what the funding policy is, what are the questions you need to answer?
You know, it's actually really one main question that we need to answer, and that is, are contributions too low? Because if you think about a pension fund, the cash that goes in are contributions and investment income on the plan assets. And the cash that goes out are benefit payments and plan expenses. So if you assume that the benefit payments are not going to be affected by anything, they're just going to be paid out as they're calculated, then if contributions are too low now, then they're going to have to rise in the future to meet the obligations. And so, and that's precisely the crowd out effect that I'm talking about. If they rise to such a level that they could crowd out the issuer's ability to pay.
And so this is not necessarily obvious in an issuer financial statement. There's not a single line or a footnote that says this is our funding policy, right? You have to dig into it a little bit. And this paper talks about how you do that. What are the key things you look at?
Well, a GASB Government Accounting Standards Board compliant financial disclosure will present a wealth of information that will allow someone to do this kind of thinking. Really, the depth of it is how you analyze the information and get this type of analysis out of it. So, one is an exhibit that relates to the contributions compared to the actuarially determined contributions. Contributions above or below, you can draw certain conclusions about that. Second is the actuary who, for the plan, will determine whether there's what's called a depletion, a fund depletion, where they expect, based on the funding policy, assets to run out of the plan before liabilities do, which is a very big red flag and really indicates that the funding is not adequate. And then there's information, and we talk about it in the white paper, about over what time period you expect unfunded liabilities to be paid down. So if they're paid down over less than 15-year period, that's a very good fact pattern. 15 to 30 years, probably a reasonable fact pattern. Longer than that, or never, which I found, and I talk about it in the paper, we have survey data of 110 plans that shows that many of them, their funding policy is never expected to pay down the unfunded liabilities, which of course is a very bad fact pattern. So these are the types of things that we can get, and we talk about how to think about it, how to find the information in the white paper.
Great. Well, thanks, Les, for doing this for the industry as well as for BAM every day. We appreciate you watching the video. Please check on the link. That'll take you directly to the white paper, or you can visit the news page at BAM's website at buildamerica.com/news and find a link to the paper from there as well. Have a great day.